Hello, and a very warm welcome to Lancaster from everyone at the Library and Learning Development Service. My name's Paul.
And I'm Leslie.
And in this video, we are going to give you a broad overview and introduction to the Library and Learning Development. We've divided the introduction into five broad themes. Theme one, the library is at the centre of your studies. In this theme, we will look at how important the library will be to your learning and research throughout your time at university.
Theme two, the library is where you are. Under this theme, we look at how you can access the library from wherever you are in the world.
In theme three, explore, discover, learn, we look at the main ways you can find information from the library, including resource lists, subject guides, and OneSearch, our library catalogue or discovery tool.
In theme four, we talk about friendly and knowledgeable staff, introducing our colleagues and showing you how they can help and support you.
And in theme five, your space to think, we have a look at the physical library building on campus. Throughout the video, we have several calls to action, small activities that you can do to help you get started. Why not pause the video when there is a call to action, complete the activity, and then restart the video. Theme one, the library is at the centre of your studies. Whatever your subject is, and regardless of the level you are studying at, the library will play an important role in you being successful at university. You will almost certainly need to use the library to find books, articles, and other resources to support your study. You may need to learn new information literacy skills or wish to improve your writing or note-taking skills. Librarians and learning developers can help you do this. Alternatively, you might need a quiet and welcoming place to study away from home. Reading, using and understanding academic material is a key part to learning at university. We don't just mean books, journals and journal articles, but also other media, films, artworks, statistical data, scientific papers, market research reports, to name but a few. Drawing on a wide range of views and resources will enrich the essays and work you produce and provide you with ideas to contribute in seminars. It will also show that you are capable of studying independently, which is a large part of learning at university. Not everything you need to access will be freely available on the internet, and this is where the library can be a real asset, somewhere where you will find good quality and trustworthy academic resources that are peer-reviewed and have been subject to an editorial process. When we asked students what was special to them about the library or what they thought the library could provide that Google couldn't, this is what they said. The library could provide relevant academic material, not just the most popular links. It was a space to study away from home. That the library provided printed and physical items. And that it had nice architecture and nice staff.
The library is more than the fantastic building at the heart of campus. So our second theme is the library is wherever you are. You'll be able to access our online content, which includes over 435,000 e-books, 47,000 e-journals, and 270 specialist databases from wherever you are studying across the world. And you can access our resources and services from several different routes, which includes the student portal, the library website, iLancaster, and Moodle. To seamlessly access our electronic content, you'll need to log in using your Lancaster username and password. You can also manage your library account online through OneSearch, our library catalogue. I'll demonstrate where and how you do that later in the video. As always, make sure you keep your password secure and remember you can reset it with our Information System Services, who are referred to as ISS. So here's our first call to action. Go to the ISS webpage and bookmark it for future reference.
Our next theme, Explore, Discover, Learn, looks at the principal ways that you can access our library resources and materials. Firstly, we have resource lists. Resource lists are electronic reading lists that link you directly to the readings and resources you need for your studies. Most, but not all courses will have a resource list, which you will be able to access through Moodle. Look out for the jigsaw icon to find your resource list. This list is for a politics module, Poly 100, and you can see it has links to electronic books and books from the library on campus, journal articles and websites. This list has been arranged by week, and there is an essential reading all students must read in preparation for the seminar.
Next, we have OneSearch. OneSearch is the library's catalogue or discovery tool, where you can search for hard copies of books held in the library, online e-books, e-journals and journal articles, as well as newspaper articles, theses and dissertations, conference papers and reports, and much, much more. As I said earlier, it's essential to log into OneSearch using your university username and password. Go to Login in the top right-hand side of the page, choose Staff and Students, and enter your details. Once you've logged in successfully, your name will appear in the top right-hand corner, and you'll be able to manage your library account online. When you start to search for a topic, book author or article, you'll see four options. Choose the full text online option and you'll be searching all of our online content. Select the books and more option and you'll find online books and journals, but also hard copies of books in the physical library. The third option is articles and more. Choose this search if you want to focus on finding journal articles. And the last option, everything, enables you to search a combination of all the other options. If I search for academic writing by the author Strongman, you can see I retrieve over 3,000 results, and the book I wanted to find is at the top of the list. Click on the title, then link for full text to open the book online. This one is from the eBook Central platform. You can choose to read it online, download the entire book for a period of 21 days, or download a PDF chapter. Copyright restrictions apply if you are downloading chapters, and as you can see here, you'll only be able to download 59 pages. This time, let's look for a book on the library shelves. First, I'll click on New Search to clear the previous details. I want to find the book Study Skills for International Postgraduates by Martin Davies. I'm going to search in the Books and More option. There are two records for this book. One is the online version and one is the print edition. To find the print copy, click on the title and you'll see that it's in the Study Skills collection on A floor at class mark JEW brackets D. If you scroll further down the page, you'll see there are five copies of this book and two are out on loan. The class mark system might seem quite complex at first, so please ask for help if you need it. Our call for action for OneSearch is for you to log in, search for a topic that you're interested in, and open an ebook.
Most ebooks allow you to read them online and on mobile devices. Print sections off within copyright law, do keyword searches within the text, make electronic notes, and export references to reference software. Another place to find information is through our library subject guides. Subject guides provide focused information, content and resources for students and researchers. They include links to class marks and finding books, journals and journal articles, news and media resources, subject-specific websites, specialist databases and training and support. These are available from the library homepage through a quick link on OneSearch and from Lancaster and the student portal. Go to the library homepage, click on the subject guide icon, and then select your guide. The This is the English and Creative Writing Guide. You can see that it has tabs for getting started, finding books and journals, and more. Our next call for action is for you to find the guide for your subject and explore the Finding Books tab. On the library homepage, you will also find a link to Learn Independently. Here you will find a range of materials to support the development of your academic and information literacy skills, including interactive online tutorials, videos, and topic guides. Our next call to action is to go to the Learn Independently webpage and find a resource which looks useful for your studies.
Our fourth theme is friendly, knowledgeable staff, where we'll share the ways you can expect to find help and support from our library and learning development teams, who are here to support you in your studies and help you get the most out of the resources the library provides. Let's start with the team of library services advisors. You'll find them at the information point by the library entrance and moving around the library building. They're also available to answer online inquiries through online chat, email and phone from 8 a.m. in the morning until 10 p.m. or midnight every day of the week. They can help you search for information on OneSearch, find books on the library shelves, answer any immediate inquiries you might have and refer you on to other services. Our call to action is to look up the contact details on the library website and send a message through our chat service if you have a question about using the library. Faculty librarians work with the academic and support staff on your course to make sure we have the right material and you have the right knowledge and skills to make the best use of library resources. If you need more in-depth help with finding information for an assignment, using resources, referencing, or using reference management tools such as EndNote, you might want to arrange an appointment with one of our faculty librarians. These are currently available online or by phone. They also provide a range of embedded workshops on your course and deliver sessions on the Central Library and Information Skills Programme. Have a look at the latest events calendar on the library website. Your next call to action, look up your faculty librarian on your subject guide. Learning developers teach and advise students on a range of study topics such as academic writing, academic reading, managing your studies, critical thinking and exam preparation. They work with students from first year undergraduates to those studying at PhD level. You can find them in the library, in each of the faculties and online, where they offer one-to-one advice and mentoring, and you may see them in faculty-based workshops. If you're an international student and English is not your first language, enrol on the English Language Development Moodle site and find out about the different ways you can develop your English. If you're an undergraduate, you can access Maths and Stats support from our Maths and Stats Learning Developer. The library is committed to providing extra support for users who are disabled, dyslexic, or have medical conditions which may affect their access to services and resources. If you need any help and assistance when using the library, please see the library staff at the information point on A floor. In addition, Fiona Rhodes has special responsibility for providing one-to-one help and training for disabled and dyslexic users in the library. She can provide personal guidance on using the library and accessing services.
Our fifth and final theme is your space to think, and this looks at the library building. The library building is at the heart of campus in Alexandra Square, next to the base and student-based services. We are open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week during term time, and from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. or midnight at most other times. We have a wide range of individual study spaces in the library, catering for a wide range of studying needs. Each space has a power socket so you can plug your laptop in or charge your phone, and there is Wi-Fi throughout the building. In normal circumstances, our doors would be open and you would be free to come and go as you please. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, however, we have had to put some measures in place to keep everyone safe. You will need to swipe your university card at the library entrance to enter the building, and you will be expected to wear a face covering throughout your visit unless you are exempt. You can visit the library to borrow and return books, but if you want to study in the library, then you will need to book an individual study space. Go to the library homepage, scroll down to the Book a Study Space icon, and then click on Book a Study Space. You can reserve a space here, and as you can see, you will need to check in and out when you arrive and leave. We advise that you clean the study space on arrival and ask that you clean it before you leave. Cleaning materials will be available nearby. To help keep the library tidy and minimise cleaning, please do not bring any food or drink into the library. The library is divided into quiet and silent zones. A floor is a quiet zone where some low-level discussion is permitted. B and C floors, the reading room, and postgraduate study space are all silent zones where no noise is allowed. Most courses now have an element of group work or require you to collaborate on projects, so the library also provide group study spaces. Many of these have interactive screens where you can plug your laptop in so you can share and discuss collaborative projects. Go to the library website, iLancaster, or the student portal to book one of these spaces. We also provide dedicated study space for postgraduates. These can be found on C floor in the library, in Graduate College, and in the Story Institute, which is in Lancaster Town Centre near the castle.
Finally today, we want to share some information about the Library Extension Project, which is progressing and will improve the library space while you are studying at Lancaster. The extension will expand the library on four floors and is due to open in early 2021. This will provide over 400 extra study spaces, as well as an informal study space on A floor, more bookable group study rooms across all floors, and a collaborative research and project space. We hope you can see through our presentation that there is so much more going on in the library than that you may have realised. If you want to know more, there are many ways that you can do this, including our FAQ webpage, which is being constantly updated. Please do get in touch. We are always happy to help. And if you use social media, you can stay in touch and keep up to date with what's going on in the library through Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.